Hello, Lancers are bound here, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer 2, Mortal Empires, and part 18 of my Clan Eshin campaign. I checked this time. God, I hope that's right. Now I'm second-guessing myself. Oh, what to do? What to do? Anyway, last time we made the S team. There might be separate requirements, though, because I don't think we can ever get Skrulk back. I think Skrulk is lost for good, unfortunately.
Not, I mean, enough warpstone.
Well, that could be the problem. I mean, I don't know. Maybe if they retake Oxal, but I'm fairly sure that if they pop up, it should be Clan Pestilence Rebels, but it's not. It's Skaven Rebels. So I don't think that Skrulk will ever return to us. Alas, he's dead for good. In some ways, that's probably... I mean, he did smell quite a lot. We tried to get him to shower, but apparently water pains him. Anyway, so I guess we'll have to use the S team for something else. What other desperate battle for survival where they get locked into a shed and come out with a fleet of battleships or something? What? How did they... Like, every single time, they'd lock them in a cupboard with everything they needed to turn like a lawnmower into a battle tank. And you're kind of like... I mean, surely word must have got around about these guys by now. Because, you know, they're in the LA underground. And I know, you know, Los Angeles is a big place, but it's surely not big enough that, you know, after like the seventh time of this group of mercenaries like jumping out of a garden shed armed with a flamethrower, the word wouldn't get around, would it? I know we didn't have the internet in those days, but still, people would call each other or write to each other, whatever. How do people talk in the old days? Did they communicate like that? Fuck knows. Anyway, surely at some point they would have gone, you know, these four guys, there's the jewelry man, him. Don't lock them in a garden shed. Just shoot them. Easier. And that would have been the end of the A-team, I guess. But how did they even get into the military? I don't think any of those haircuts were... regulation. There's so many questions I have. Anyway, so...
Clan Eshin assassinating.
Yes, good. Not escape. Now, we do have Thorgrim down here. That's a problem. That's not a problem, but I think... Oh, we've also got... Oh, fuck's sake.
You can't ask this of me.
Oh, I've got Belagar up here as well now.
Pestilence.
Oh, God, they're everywhere. Oh, this is the worst. Son of a... Right, well, we need to deal with these guys. Yes, well, that's hopeful. And then we need to kill the Greenskins. We need to wipe out the Greenskins, or at least, like, you know, really stymie them, because it looks like they're starting to, like, get more stuff again. And that's not... I don't want that. Oh, we also stab Manfred, not Vlad. We stab Manfred, the moon-faced goon. Manfred is now super dead. And considering that Manfred is the reason that the Warhammer world was destroyed in the end times, because basically all of the... What were they? Archons? You know, they had, like, the big guy of... Like, Grimgor was the thing of beasts, wasn't he? And, like, Nagash was of undeath. And Alariel... No. Alariel was life? I can't fucking remember. Wasn't Alariel killed? I feel like at some point Games Workshop just went, right, we're doing the end times. They just had this big, big dartboard, like, with all of the Warhammer special characters. And they just threw a dart. And they went, okay, Belagar has been... And there's another dartboard with certain situations. Belagar, another dart, makes love to, another dart, Skrulk. Fair enough, that's what happens in the end times. Fuck it, that's how he dies. And, I mean, would certainly kill you. And, oh, the mental image. Just some soft jazz going in the background. Good. What a way to go. And so that's how they killed the... But anyway, so Manfred basically had a hissy fit right at the end of the end times. They're about to save the day. Manfred had a hissy fit and killed some one of them. And then, of course, everything failed and the entire world was destroyed. So by assassinating Manfred, Deathmaster Snitch has saved the entire world. That must count for... Like, that must, like, wipe away most of his crimes. Not all of them, but most of them.
Warp scroll.
Oh, goggle rats. How much... A line hunt? What the fu... Okay, I mean, hopefully this will be being built up, so... Expand the Undercity. I mean, it's not a bad place to expand the Undercity. And then we can go north and... we should maybe put one in Hwattle as well.
Get off
Maybe? I don't know. Right, okay, yeah, we'll go south.
When ready.
Good. And so we're going to go south. We can block armies. I don't really know why I want to do that. It's not really a big deal. Triven. Oh, we've got so many friggin' agents wandering around. Can you stab this guy? No, because we don't have any money. Oh, okay. Okay, this is fine. This is fine. I just want some vision over what the orcs are doing, to be honest.
Clan Eshin assassin in. Night runner.
Okay, you're not doing anything. Virus, can you hinder replenishment? Oh, holy shit! You actually managed it. Holy fuck. You actually succeeded in an agent action. Admittedly, it was pointless because that army isn't actually wounded. So you could actually be lying to me here. You might have gone, yes, I was successful, boss. I wouldn't know. I would not know. I didn't move Ulysses. Hello? Oh, you're coming in, are you? Because you're actually attacking the garrison, and I'm coming in as reinforcements. Oh, that's exciting. Yeah, sure, I'm in. Well, they spotted Deathmask Snitch because once again he has become visible. It wasn't even the amazing visible rat that got spotted. Nope. Deathmaster Snitch was spotted. He's now hidden again. He's like he got spotted and then hit. I don't know whether that's a bug or what. The Wheels of Doom. Rolling over to the right flank. We're going to move the amazing visible rat over to there as well. The Gutter Runner is now advancing forward. Meanwhile, our allies' garrison is taking a bit of a pounding for us, but that's what they're there for. They're sacrificial. And these Black Orcs approaching our Gutter Runners. They're very, very slow. And they have no shield. So basically, that the worst thing you can possibly send against Gutter Runners. Especially Eshin Gutter Runners, because they're out of here. And we do have some more Black Orcs and some handguns as well. The handguns could be potentially quite nasty. If they're allowed to live. It'd be nice if you, like, you know, spread your shots rather than... See, that was fine. Look at these Black Orcs getting absolutely rinsed. Yeah, another unit of them just being annihilated. Just not very good at dealing with shurikens, are they? Going down hard. Another unit of black... I mean, they're just sending the Black Orcs at us piecemeal, which, of course, is the worst... You don't want to send Black Orcs piecemeal. So they're getting caught out and torn to shreds. However, the main bulk of the army is still fighting for the moment. We've knocked out the cannon, and now our infantry... is moving in to knock out some of these handguns, chase them off. A few handguns taking pot shots at us. There's not much they can do. In come the triads and the Death Runners sweeping in to knock out those Black Orcs. They're kind of surrounded. More the sneaky stabbers coming in from the flank, and they're getting shot in the back. Be nice if the catapult wasn't targeting us. The Gutter Runners, having annihilated multiple units of Black Orcs, now moving in to mop up the remaining army, which is so busy with the garrison forces that they just haven't spotted what's coming in from behind. They're out of here. I mean, that was both easier and more annoying, because obviously the units were all over the place rather than I could herd them. But that was fine. I mean, we have what we wanted. They are mostly defeated. We can easily finish them off next turn. I'm going to take the money. I very rarely do that, but I'm going to take the money. What's this? Oh no, not a Skaven has been stabbed. That's not good. Was he a Skaven? Was he not? We'll never learn until he respawned. And we've also got some more money coming in, so that's quite nice. Because we've got the Thieves' Hidey Hole in Lothurn. Did we get another... I thought so we got another settlement, but maybe I just made that up in my head. Just wishful thinking. Right, where... Where have you gone? You can't have got far. You haven't headed south. You must be... you're laying in ambush. There you are, you sneaky little bugger. Come back. I haven't finished with you. Bop. Oh, I forgot to put all the banners on as well. right, you get... Yeah, and you get... Yeah, and then everything else goes on the Death Runners. No particular rhyme or reason. Let's... Food. Let's take the food. Right, we've all got a totem of rust. Minus 16 R. Oh, that's quite nice. That is nice, but I feel like the campaign movement range is better. Is it? Oh, fuck it. Fuck it. I'm going to take the... Yeah, fuck it. See if I care. I'm going to get Death Frenzy because I quite like Death. Oh, you've got two skill points. In that case, I have Evasion as well. That'll hopefully keep you alive longer. Amazing visible rats. And I go fleet-footed. Sure. You've got more fleet of foot than expected. And Splinter. You can damage walls and spread corruption. Where is no. Where's Snitch gone? He was around here. Oh, fucking, I'm going to go looking for him, aren't I? Snitch. You got stabbed. Oh, right. Yes. Okay, good. Well, you're back soon, so that's fine. That's fine. Master assassin. Oh god, look at that army. That's a big mishmash of shit, isn't it? I hide. Oh, I might have to. Right, if I go... No, because you're going to take attrition there, you stupid bastard. There you go. As we swear, I told him to go there. No, you wanker! You're going to get attrition, you idiot.
Warlock, master of Scryer.
Yes, indeed. Let's get the Warpstone Reactor. Lovely. Lovely stuff. We've got some undercities kind of quite growing here, which is quite... I like spreading my undercities. I like spreading them wide. You know me. Spread my undercities far and wide, I do. Rat spreading. That's what it is. Right, let's... Oh, we've got another army growing here. Fine. That is not rebelling. I want you to rebel. I want you to get out of here, basically. I don't want to deal with you anymore.
I like it, you. I'll not eat you just yet, until we have packed.
I mean, that sounds fair enough. I can't argue with that. You are slowly deteriorating because you don't like... you do like clan wars. Okay, good. You like my hero actions against Kazakarak. You like my war with the mercenaries. You like my war with, well, most people, to be honest. I'm at war with a lot of people. And that's generally cheering you up, I guess, is fine. I hope they manage to deal with Thorgrim. I haven't been paying attention to that. Where is Thorgrim still around? It doesn't look like he is. But I'm always nervous about what the AI, especially dwarves. Sneaky dwarves. Hello, sir. From Lorlorn, fuck me, mate. You're from all the way up here, and you've wandered all the way down here. Why? God, yeah, that felt good. Shanking the wood elf. Stitch is back, good. Where is he? All the way down there. Of course he fucking is. Of course he is. Wine. Oh, hello. Hello. You meandering this way, are you? That's unfortunate for you. Get him! Oh, this is going to be good. Now, dealing with these cavalry units is the most important thing, and so we're going to lure them into a bit of a trap. So we've got their attention by using the Gutter Runner Slingers, and they are fleeing around this little corner here, and then we're going to move in with the Gutter Runners, give them another little dose of shuriken fire. And then we've got Ulysses and his assassin squad just behind. See these guys chasing. And there we go, they're now stuck in place, nicely blobbed up. We can now move the Gutter Runners in to get some lovely shots in there. Look at that, doing so much damage. And then, of course, we can drop a lovely little vortex on their heads. Poor old Gara getting chucked away, but that's fine. In comes the vortex. And they're going to be losing a lot of health there. Okay, that's one flank dealt with. Now we just need to deal with the rest of the army. They do have more boar boys on the far flank, but they are far away and no concern as of yet. We're pulling back up the top of the hill. Got the Eshin Triads held in reserve just in case we need them. We've managed to deal with most of those boar boys. Boar boys charging in. Now, we were braced, but got thrown around quite a bit, which I feel is unfair, because we should have tanked that fairly well, and we didn't. They do have charge defense versus large, but apparently didn't fucking work, did it? Never mind. Okay, so we've got some boar boys. Yeah, we've tied these guys up with some sacrificial clan rats, and our Gutter Runners pulling away from the main force now. Moving assassin squad in to tank the left flank. It's a little bit dicey, but we're probably fine. We do have some more boar boys advancing this direction, but they're getting tied up dealing with those clan rats. And here comes some Stotling Pump wagons. These things are literally the worst, and so we're going to deal with them with the utmost prejudice. Lots of fire. They are very susceptible to the old shurikens. The river trolls charging in. And then kind of stopping short. I don't quite know why. They're not... Maybe they don't want to charge the Eshin Triads? I don't know. But either way, they're not very happy about being hit with my balls. And then the Eshin Triads charging. The Death Runners moving around the flank. Getting a lovely little vortex on this big blob of units there. This is doing so much damage. It's a bit of a mosh pit, though. Bit of a mess. Well, War Boss is in there as well. And, poor old Toxide getting charged by a bunch of Savage Orc Boar Boys. He should be fine here, but they're sort of almost breaking, but also not. So this is a bit of a mess, but the Gutter Runners are picking off units where they can, getting some shots in on those Savage Orc Boar Boys. The Eshin Triads holding the line. The Death Runners picking off units where they can. We've got this battle sewn up, but we do need to help out Hero Squad, who are a little bit beleaguered, which is why we've got the Death Runners charging in to get a little backstab there. It's looking quite good. Death Runners charging in. That should cause a lot of damage. We also need to help out Toxide, who's got a Goblin Big Boss chasing after him, so that needs to be dealt with. A little fireball coming out there just to cause some damage. These Orc Boar Boys need to die. Death Runners are doing that for us. There they go, running them down. The Gutter Runners picking off everyone who is fleeing. And there we go, mass routes now happening. Death Runners chasing down anyone they can find. We're going to send the Gutter Runners to hunt down other units as well. That Orc War Boss is he's trying to make a getaway, and I am not in favour of that. So we're actually, while the Gutter Runners are sort of chasing down Orcs left, right and centre, we're actually going to send in Ulysses and his buddies to go and hunt down that Orc War Boss. He's quite slow anyway, but then we can freeze him in place and finish him off. I mean, that was a very fun battle. Just picking that enemy army apart piece by piece was very satisfying. Master assassin. Good. Oh, Ulysses. Good fucking job, mate. Just that was quite a nasty army as well, and just iced it. We go here. We won't get attrition damage, so let's do that. Let's ambush as well. Ulysses immortality. Of course he needs it. Oh, he's been so good. This is like, I really like the what I you know what I would like to see is some way to sort of special. I mean, I know you can sort of specialize characters as they are, but I would kind of like the ability to, like, recruit, say, a Skaven warlord and then decide, actually, this is going to be like an Eshin assassin, and then trait him that way and for his, like, looks to change. That's kind of what I want. It's a bit more RPG than strategy, but I quite like the blend of both of those, to be honest. And I really like
Master Assassin.
Like the Dark Elf names, right? So when you get is it level 10 or 20 or something, you can pick a trait and then you get a random selection. I want more of that. I want a way to sort of go, okay, what is this character? And to get like, okay, so he's actually very good with shades. So therefore, we're going to fill his army out with shade or make him sort of shade army heavy. Something like that. I really like that. They should do more of that, in my opinion. Definitely. Okay, we'll grab that. Excellent. Now, I don't know where this army has gone. There's an army over here somewhere. They might have legged it. Okay, they're over there. I think... Oh, no, they've got an army down there as well. Stabby, stabby. Holy shit. I said stab, not genocide. Okay, you're dead as well. Excellent. That's double good. I guess be an opportunist for no particular reason. This army needs to die. I mean, more so than it already is. Queek is not dealing with this very well, is he? How is Queek doing?
I smell you. I am superior, Skaven. Lower tier.
Okay. Well, Alright, I wonder if...
Threatened, a jackal shows its belly, an act of submission. You are the jackal.
I'm a rat. It's different. I mean, you're a skeleton. You don't have eyes. I'm not surprised you can't really work out what the fuck I am, to be honest. But that's fine. Never mind. I could confederate with Queek, but again, I keep thinking, should I do this? And I feel like not having to worry about, like, this and this is actually in my favour rather than having to... So I'm going to leave Queek to his own devices, I think. I'm just going to let him do his own thing. I might confederate Clan Scryer. But again, if I do that, then I have to deal with all this shenanigans and...
I will not blight my soul.
You know, do I want that? Do I?
Of Skaven blight.
I mean, you're doing all right for yourself. What the fuck is this? Border Prince Rebels. I don't think I've ever seen Border Prince Rebels before. There we go. Well, there's Grimgor.
Not doing it.
There's Grimgor Ironhide, which means the orcs have at least three stacks.
You dare approach me.
On 8 settlements. I mean... They've managed to carve themselves out a little empire here, haven't they? Which is actually, you know, I guess because they haven't had the... they're at war with literally everyone, apart from Khemri, who like strong... I mean, you can say what you like about old Setra. He does, you know, he sees a big muscly man flexing and he's like, ooh, I like that. He does. So, I mean, I'm not judging. That's fine. You know, who doesn't like a big, muscly empire? Big, meaty empire. Good. And who's this? Hello. You're dead. I don't really know why. I just felt like he was being a bit obnoxious. I've got some rebels over here as well. Greenskin rebels there. So lots of rebels here, but that was to be... Jeez, Vlad is... look what Vlad's doing. He has lost a little bit of territory over here. Is he at war with Wissenland now? No. Oh, I thought he'd lost Wissenberg, but no, maybe not. Maybe he never had that. Maybe he never had it, but it looks like he's like gobbling up the... he's a gobbler. Vlad is a gobbler. It's official. Vlad is gobbling up all those...
Cease.
well, all the places which don't have massive rebel armies in them, which is apparently all of them. So that's fun. Good, lovely. Good. Metastone, I'm going to have a look over here, actually.
Sneak scurry.
Yeah, sneak scurry. You go over there.
Clan Eshin assassin in.
Good. You come down here. I want to know. Basically, I want to take Ekrand. I want to take all of this so that the Greenskins don't have it. And Mount Silverstone, you definitely need defences. Because if you don't have defences, the dwarves will just walk in.
Thief in the villainous night.
Now, we do have an... can I actually see what the... oh, yes, I can. Okay, so you've got a mine shaft. You've got a warp token mine. You've got a raiding camp and deeper tunnels. So, I don't think this is... So, yeah. It's not actually causing us any issues. And it would cost a lot to get rid of. So I'm kind of like, meh. Just a big old meh. I think is what I'm going to say. Big old meh. Not bothered. Not that bothered. I tell you what, I do need a bloody gold mine here. And warpstone reactors to make the gold mine good. Hello, Belagar. Oh, you're coming this way, are you? That does not look fun to intercept. So I'm going to say no. Belagar is coming this way, though. That is a problem. That is problematic. Okay. Yeah. Hello. Oh, your army is... Wow. What the fuck happened there?
Warlock, master of Scry.
Is your army always like that? Okay, I'm recruiting those boys. I'm recruiting those boys. You are trying to make a run for it. And stab. Skitter, scatter. Okay, how much move have we got left? So I can go like there. I can go there. Perfect. Oh, it's not fucking, Jesus. You fucking guys. If I can get an ambush, I've got the ambush. Good. Let's kill those guys. The Totem of Rust, I'm going to pop on like you guys, I think. Okay, Gernhardt's mercenaries are dead. Killing mercenary armies is a pain in the ass, but we have done it. Can I move anywhere where I'm not going to get attrition? Yes, I can go there. Perfect. Let's get a little bit of replenishment. That'll be nice. Moving you over there. Belagar is a problem. In fact, we could get the S team over here, couldn't we? Maybe this is what the S team are for. Go and kick the shit out of some little beardy people. If no one else can help, if you can find them, maybe you can hire the S team if we have enough money to get them to do agent actions against the resulting blob. Good. I think Thorgrim might have gone down, so I think we might be okay on that. But Belagar is a problem, and we need to hold the dwarves at bay while we knock out the Greenskins. That's basically what we need to be doing. So, what I do need to do is either upgrade the gold mine or get this. So I'm going to get that, because that's only going to get three turns, going to increase our money very, very nicely. Can I stab you? No. Well, you say that, but you didn't actually stab him, did you? You didn't stab the person that I wanted you to stab. Grimgor's over there. He needs to die. Wish I'd called in Queek to fight the Greenskins. Although, frankly, at the time, I think it would have been I think Grimgor would have just started eating up Queek's territory, and that would have made things worse for me, so... Wow, that's a whole stack, isn't it? And then all that as well. Basically... I think Castle Drakenhof is very firmly in rebel hands and probably won't be coming out anytime soon, because that's a lot of very tough dead things right there. I hadn't realised. I thought that the rebel territories would basically just be free real estate, but it looks like actually it's quite hard to take them because they have entire stacks and garrisons in them. So I mean that's good, I guess, because it means it's just gonna... I mean, they are slowly being taken. It looks like Vlad's taking quite a few of them, actually, which is gonna put a stop to Wissenberg gaining more strength. Do we know who's strength rank 1 yet? So Bretonians are 2. Holy shit. How are you strength rank 2? How the fuck are you strength... Oh, you probably got all of the... you probably got all this as well, haven't you?
I am the blood of Gilles.
Yeah, yeah. And...
Mighty am I.
Well, that's going up.
You can trust faith. Look at my long, lengthy, many-segmented tail.
That's not your tail. Good. So, we're going to come down here. I need to whack an undercity in... Oh, there is. I thought Whattle was further away, but no, it's right there. We still need 7 turns. Okay, no, that's fine. That's fine. I also need to expand my under... Basically, I need more money and I don't have enough. I mean, is that not ever the problem of literally everyone on the planet, except for those people who have too much money and still want more? And I wish that was me! But Kalador's running away again. They just seem to be, like, legging it back across the Badlands, terrified of the incoming Skaven hordes, but I don't know what they expected, to be honest. I'm bored of all of that. Oh dear. Well, ambush failed, but that's not really a big deal. Nom nom nom. Oh, look. Wurzag snuck right by us. He's heading for Black Crag. That's not good. There's no one there to stop him. Well, apart from Moss's face. What's this? Ally? Okay, I'm going to help Vlad. Let's help Vlad, Daddy. Make up for me hurling abuse at him the other episode when it was actually Manfred I was angry at. Maybe that's like a deep... Maybe I'm angry at Vlad for some reason. But... Oh, Karaberg, lovely. And you're all dead. Perfect. Okay, let's go and grab this. I'll just go loot and occupy at rank 1. I think most of this should be fairly easy to take. I'm going to send Thyrus up there to damage the walls. Another success for Thyrus. Wow. Maybe he's turned it around. Holy shit. Okay. I don't know where you can get to. That's a problem. I don't want you to turn around and attack me. You can reach there. So I reckon you can probably reach about there. Ish. So I really wish you could see, like... Because I can see where he can move if he's marching, but obviously he can't attack me when he's marching. I can't see where he can move normally because he's not in a normal stance. Which is annoying because the AI knows perfectly where it can move to. So I'm fairly sure I'm safe here.
Marching, marching. Forget it. Sneaky snake.
But if I'm not, he can jump me, which is a bit... Flensing Ruin is garbage. Crack's Call is not actually too bad, so we'll grab that one, I think.
Unseen Killer.
And you know what? I'm going to save all of the skill points until the end of the episode and sort of like do them all at once, because otherwise it's just going to get incredibly annoying watching me assign fucking skill points to the bajillion fucking agents that apparently I have decided to recruit. We could get walls. It's not going to help us right away. I don't think he can attack us right away either. So I think we're generally okay. So we should have a little bit of time. Belagar's pulling back. Or at least he's meandered that way. We are going to recruit some storm vermin, I've decided. And the S team are required over here. Because turns out the baddies, instead of locking us in a garden shed, decided to just run away. Which, to be honest, probably sensible. Should we try stealing technology? 69, the sexiest amount of percent chance. And we succeeded. He flaunted his little rat body at the lizards, and they just gave him whatever he wanted. Who can blame them? Right, you can not stab that one, because we don't have enough money. You can just meander up. Basically, I'm trying to keep an eye... There's Grimgore's there, so we can keep an eye on Grimgore. And Wurzak, except for that, we've killed the other army, so I don't think they've got any other armies. I think that's probably it. I'm just going to meander up there past the Necromancer with a big, big pile of bodies being pulled by more bodies.
Silent killer. Yes, yes.
I mean, it's... I'm not against their mode of transportation. I just, like, it's quicker to walk. I guess you don't have to, like... I guess you save your legs a bit if you're getting the... But in that case, just you know, get one Zomble, give you a piggyback ride. I mean, it'd be horrible, but then he's already stood in front of a big pile of bodies, so I don't think it really bothers him that much, in all honesty. I don't think he's particularly perturbed by... So, just get one Zomble, give you a piggyback ride. Job, that's two stacks of dwarves. I did not realise there was two stacks of dwarves there. That is an issue. Hello. Well, I thought I was out of range. Apparently, I was not. In spite of that, it still says it's very much in our favour, which is nice, but somewhat confusing. They don't have a... I mean, they've got a couple of units of cavalry there. The Orc Board chariots are a bit of a problem, but actually our Eshin gutter runners can take those down pretty quickly. The Boar Boy's a little bit of a problem. Everything else, not too bad. It's not any problem. So if we can knock out their fast-moving units, which is ever the problem, then that should be fairly straightforward. But that is going to have to wait until next time. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.